Oh.
They know we're gone now.
Make tracks. Don't leave any tracks, though. Just make tracks. Yeah, locomotive speed. Oh, boy. He's still that messed up? He looked better at practice. These guys
are thought, isn't it?
Starving.
Roderick! There you are. Lady Forrester!
What's wrong, Mother?
It's Gryff. He was arguing with the Maester and things got out of hand.
Uh-oh.
I'm coming. What do you mean to do?
Maester Ortengrin?
This could be our chance.
He's right. We must hurry.
We must protect the Maester.
I'll make sure the Maester is safe. That's what matters.
Just don't forget your promise, Roderick.
The rest of my men are still in the grove. They could be here in minutes.
Get them ready to do damage.
Make sure they're ready to do some damage.
Sounds like a good time. Let's go.
I like that guy. I like the look in his eyes.
Listen for my signal.
I'll strike fire.
My pain when I want you to enter. We'll be ready.
Be ready to strike that cane, guys.
I'm coming with you.
It's not safe. You should wait for your brother.
I don't care if it isn't safe. Gryff thinks I belong to him. I need to show him I don't.
Right.
Together then.
She's pissed. Do I actually have hope? Do I want to have hope? Are we actually not going to be bullied for an entire episode? That'd be awesome. Oh. Can we tell him to stop now?
Roderick, help me. Tell your dog to obey his new master.
Dog, bite master.
While you're at it. Elena Glenmore, what are you doing with him? You're supposed to be marrying
you.
Me.
You? I'd rather marry a dead horse.
You watch your bloody tongue, or I'll give you what I'm giving the maester.
Excuse Release the maester. Me?
Let the maester go, Gryff.
Not until he's learned his lesson. He's disobedient, just like you were, Roderick. Before I brought you to heel. So now he's paying the price.
Ooh!
My hand!
Sorry. I'm Lord here, not you.
Don't believe you.
You're not the Lord here, Gryff. And I'm tired of you pretending you are.
You think I'm fucking pretending.
Gryff didn't like that. He's not supposed to like it.
You know what I think?
My brother is ready.
Awesome.
I think you need another lesson in humility. Just like your maester here. You can watch if you like. Then you'll see who's the man and who's the cripple.
Summon.
I've let you off too fucking easily, Roderick.
E. Oh yeah, that look of surprise.
What the hell is this?
You are doomed.
What are your orders?
I'm the only one here who gives the orders. What are you waiting for?
Take their weapons.
Take their weapons.
What are you doing?
Taking your weapons.
Drop it.
Now.
This is my hall! You have no right to be here!
It's not your hall.
Now then, about humility.
Get your hands off me!
Maester, Are you all right?
Loving this.
I think so.
Loving.
My father will go straight to Roose Bolton. You flayer. I'm your sister and you're all
shut your mouth.
Shut your bloody mouth, Rick.
You gonna hurt me? Your friends won't be around forever, Roderick. And when they're gone, I will see that you pay for this.
Punch.
Is this the man you'd rather have? This cripple.
I think he wants more. Roderick!
Enough! That's enough! Are you satisfied?
Back out.
Is that it then?
Spit on him.
Fuck you, Roderick.
Everyone will remember that.
Find the White Hilt to the cellars. No one gets in or out.
This isn't over, Roderick!
I hope the good people don't think less of him now. Now that everyone's remembering that. I mean, we don't know if it's in a good way or a bad way. Oh, that felt so damn
world
good.
Cannot reach High Point. You must be sure of it. Not as long as they still hold Ryan.
You gotta take out all his men. No one leaves.
Kill the Ravens. All of them.
Kill the Ravens? Right, no messages.
I swear I will!
Fuck you and your queen!
That's enough! So long as you're in my camp, you will obey my orders. And getting pissed drunk before a mission.
Okay.
You know what kind of shit-brained fool does that? One who wants to fucking die out there. Have you lost your damn mind?
I am not some animal in a cage.
Nice to see you two bonding.
I'm glad to see you two are getting along. Warms the heart.
I'm not the one with the problem. It's him.
She can't fight like this, Asher.
You think I'm too drunk to fight? What the fuck do you
What are you,
you
gonna
know?
Do? When are they swinging a fucking...
Ooh.
Still think I can't fight?
More fisticuffs.
You fucking bitch!
Oh, there we go.
Break it up.
Hey, come on, Beskha. Leave the poor man
alone. Let go of me before I break your fingers.
Deal with your friend. She'll get us all
you
killed.
You sound scared, Croft.
This is bloody important.
You afraid your mother will spank you?
I will not let you two fuck this
are you
up.
Looking
I'll talk to her.
I'll talk to her.
Good. If she can't hold it together, we're leaving without the both of you.
You think your little thumbcock can take Marine all by itself? I'd never work with a bloody show like you
Beskha,
anyway!
What the hell is going on?
What's a show?
You gonna lecture me too?
Oh! I wasn't prepared for that.
Croft doesn't know shit about anything.
Stop now trying to hit me.
Will you stop trying to hit me? Whatever your problem is with Croft, just let it go.
You think this is about Croft? You think I give two shits about what Croft has to say?
I'm ready. I got my hands on the keyboard.
Your fucking uncle's the only reason I'm even here. He told your little dragon queen I would go into Marine with you. You brought me here.
Just talk to me. Oh, it's for my family. I hit the wrong one.
Always about you. Your family. Your problems.
Too late. Oh. Okay. I'm a little slow tonight. I'm sorry.
Oh, if this was a real fight, you'd be dead. You want to help? Come
refuse.
On.
I'm not going to do that.
Not going to fight our friend. Ah. That's my hair. Oh, damn it. Damn it. You're going to kill me?
So what? You're going to kill me because you don't want to go into some fucking city.
She's afraid of something. Yep.
Here, in this fucking city. I was taken from my home when I was only 3 years old. When I was 7, my master threw me in the fighting pits to die. When my master tired of watching me kill animals for sport, he started.
He started sending other children.
Hmm. And you?
I've butchered every one of them.
Hmm.
After a while, I thought the fear was gone. I thought I was used to it.
It's horrible.
Lance, what kind of a monster would do that to a child?
To him, we were not children. We were his playthings. His entertainment. There was his boy. We used to play five stones in the alley when we couldn't sleep. When I saw him next, he was in that pit with me. I saw the fear in his eyes. That same fear I felt my first time. And I realized it hadn't left me. I still wanted to live. I wanted it so badly. My master watched as I did it. Smiling. I could have killed him for that fucking smile.
I'm sorry, Beskha.
I'm so sorry, Beskha.
I don't want your pity.
Noticed it. But will she remember it?
I got my freedom a long time ago, but I have always hated this place. Hated him. Dezor Zoraza. Because of that man.
Well, maybe we can get revenge on him now. Or you can.
Marine is a city of dead children.
There's a lot of people still living there now, and we can help them.
I won't let you down.
I know you won't.
I know you won't.
Should we be more forceful with taking a drink from her? Is she going to show up drunk and mess everything up? I just don't want to be callous either. Tommen's coronation feast.
Why not?
Who's this?
Mira. I'll meet you inside.
I forgot who that guy is.
What are you doing here? I have to get in there, Sarah. I know I'm not supposed to attend. But then you know Lady Marjorie doesn't want to see you. What could be so important?
Conspiracy against my family.
Lord Whitehill is up to something. He's conspiring against my family. And someone in there is helping him.
Lady Marjorie would be furious, Mira. I can't. I'm sorry. I want to help you. But I can't risk it.
I'll take the blame.
You can tell Marjorie I snuck in and you tried to stop me. She's already thinking about replacing you.
Are you sure you want to risk it?
I have to.
I guess we have to.
All right. You owe me for this.
Hmm.
She's with me. We'll stay out of trouble. I promise.
You've had bad run-ins with some of these soldiers, these guards. I don't trust any one of them.
Feels a bit strange to celebrate, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Not so long ago, King Joffrey sat on the Iron Throne.
Tommen is our king now.
Long may he reign.
Yeah, we'll say.
Sarah! I was worried you'd run off with your friend there.
And what if I did?
It's been, what, 2 minutes?
I'm not sure I could blame you.
My God.
This is Lady Mira Forrester. Mira? Lord Garibald Tarwick.
Right, Tarwick.
She's quite lovely. Where have you been hiding her?
You're making her blush.
Sarah's the lovely one.
You flatter me. Sarah's lovelier than us all.
I won't argue there. It's quite a feast, isn't it?
He looks like 20
Just
years older than her.
Be careful around the wine. I hear you're partial to a particular Arbor Red. It's easy to forget. Nothing you do in King's Landing goes unnoticed.
Is
Drink
she?
Drink too much once and you're forever the drunken fool. Talk to the wrong people.
Oh,
and...
Lord Tarwick!
Who's that? Who is that?
What was that about?
Nothing. That subject isn't fit for your delicate ears anyway.
White Hill.
My ears are not delicate.
Is that White Hill?
Of course they are. Look how tiny they are. Little loads.
Stop it.
What?
I mean it. Someone called
And that looks like Roderick, too, but can't be. Lord Morgan and Lord Andros.
I just noticed Lords Andros and Morgan over there.
What a shame. Ruining a perfectly good afternoon with that nonsense.
Perhaps someone should encourage them to argue elsewhere. If you'll excuse me.
So they're the ones we need to talk to.
The tourney at Lannisport. You wouldn't believe it.
You told me this story.
But you would have loved it. We danced all evening, drank wine from our helmets.
That is it!
He's a White Hill, isn't he?
You're being ridiculous!
He looks like a White Hill. I don't remember them, guys. I'm sorry. I know it's from last episode, or the one before. Okay, we get to look around now. Talk to, eavesdrop, Sarah and Tarwick. Andros, Morgan. I kind of want to eavesdrop on them. Can we? Will it, like, take away these options? Will they notice if we eavesdrop? Let's not eavesdrop. Eavesdrop on Morgan. Where's she going?
And why would you ever stop dealing iron?
Is there no longer a demand?
I can't imagine that would be the case.
No need for such wild speculation. I've simply lost interest. I'm moving on to better things, as they say.
And what would that be?
No. I can see what you're doing. I'm not giving away my secrets just yet.
Can we eavesdrop on them? Will people notice? We'll be in trouble.
I heard he was killed. Right here in the garden.
Well. Wasn't he a Lannister?
One of their guard, but still.
Right, the guard we had to kill. In self-defense.
No, they haven't caught him yet. Not for lack of effort, mind you. I hear they've spared no expense.
I like eavesdropping. Ha ha, that's pretty cool. Look at the view. Why not? Take our time, see the sights.
It seems so calm out there.
Yep. Unlike here. Oh wait, can we eavesdrop on him? How do we get over to... Oh, look at the food. Yep, that's food, alright. The only adventure game where you look at something and you literally just look at it. Can you have some? Is that cheese? What the hell is that? I have no idea what we just ate. Let's eavesdrop on them, why not? No one else noticed when we eavesdrop on them.
Oh, I can't remember. I think it was a bird?
Oh, close.
A cock.
That's it.
No, that's terrible.
Double entendres.
Telling the joke, remember?
Yeah, they're just telling jokes. Eavesdrop on Andros. He's gotta be a White Hill. I mean, he probably is, and you guys know.
It is a lot, but I know how to say it.
But how did he manage it?
Lord Whitehill trusts me above all others. That's why I'm the only one he's willing to...
Well, he works with the White House.
Oh, an exclusive deal. How good for you, Andros.
Well, I've got my family to consider.
When's the last time you even saw your wife, Andros?
Where's she going now? Okay. Oh! We got wine we can look at. And drink. Ah.
I recognize that wine.
He knows not to drink the wine. That might have been, a thing.
Sarah? Lord Tarwick?
Well met, Lady Mira. I hope you're enjoying yourself. Have you had any luck?
Luck? With what?
This place is full of eligible men.
I assumed you were on the lookout for a husband.
That isn't really what Mira's interested in.
Nonsense. You must have your eye on someone.
Oh, don't press her, Garibald.
I'm only curious. No harm in that. You can tell me. I can keep a secret, can't I, Sarah?
Tell me about Morgan.
Can you tell me about Lord Morgan?
He's a handsome fellow, isn't he? He has an odd reputation, though.
Does he?
People say he's dangerous, but I couldn't say why.
I didn't know that. Thank you, Lord Tarwick. I should be going.
Stay out of trouble, Mira.
That was a flirty look she gave him.
Hello again, Lady Mira.
Goodness, Mira. I didn't expect to see you back so soon.
I didn't even walk away.
Please excuse me.
Okay, we can't ask anything more. That was funny. Let's talk to Andros. Should we? Should we talk? No. I don't like him. I don't like dealing with anyone that looks or deals anything remotely White Hill. Let's talk to Morgan. Life of the party, I see.
Please, if you'll excuse me.
Now, if you'll excuse
Mira,
me.
I'm impressed.
Impressed with what?
That you aren't currently locked in a cell.
I beg your pardon?
I trust this means that you took care of that contract. How did you do it?
Right.
If I may ask?
He knows about that.
I was expecting to see you again, if I'm being honest.
Every secret. Every secret has
if
a price.
I tell you how I did it. What's in it for me?
Nothing. But I admire the gall.
Thanks.
I do believe King's Landing is rubbing off on you.
That's not a good thing, I don't think.
What have you been up to?
Enjoying yourself?
I suppose if you're talking to me, you must want something.
Why were you arguing with Andros?
I noticed you and Andros arguing earlier.
I'm sorry you had to see that. I told him it was not the time.
What were you arguing about, if you don't mind my asking?
Well, a bold question deserves a bold answer, doesn't it?
Sure.
I've been pushed out of the Ironwood business.
Oh.
Really?
All thanks to my partner. Bloody imbecile. Andros is now Lud Whitehill's exclusive contact in King's Landing. No matter the fact that I introduced them in the first place.
Why did he push you out?
Nothing without me.
Why would Lord Andros want to push you out?
He found a man he could manipulate. Someone who wouldn't demand an equal share. Lyman Lannister.
Lyman Lannister?
With a Lannister?
Who's that?
A third cousin, to be fair.
Some Whenever distant Andros Lannister.
He clearly thinks Lyman can take my place.
That's him? That's Lyman?
Rickard! Are you done flirting with that handmaiden? We need your opinion here.
Leave him alone.
Please excuse me.
Lyman Lannister. So that's who that is. Can we eavesdrop again? Or it'll just be the same thing.
I've already told you, and didn't we agree to stop talking business?
All right, Rickard. How about something more personal then?
Oh, you're calling me Rickard now.
Well, when are you going to get married?
Isla!
That took a turn, didn't it?
Mm.
You didn't answer the question.
Escalated quickly. Alright, so they're not talking about anything we care about. So, let's eavesdrop on Andros some more, and then I guess we'll actually talk to him. Don't mind me, gonna go sit here on this bench.
And Lannister, too.
I thought we were done talking about this.
You asked me about my friends.
Friends? Yes, Lyman is your business partner.
What's the difference?
Fair enough, Andros.
And if my friends happen to protect me from the crowd, all the better.
I think I need more wine.
Anyone needs a drink, but talking to that guy. I think we need it. Should I actually talk to him? I can't think it would turn out very well. We don't want to. Oh, we can't. We can't talk to him now. Alright, so where's this Lyman guy? There he is. Lyman Lannister.
Excuse me. Lyman Lannister?
Shit. You startled me.
Let me help.
I don't already have enough to deal with.
Here, let me help.
That's very kind of you. Thank you. But I'm fine.
A little on edge, are you?
I just get clumsy sometimes.
Huh. Poor guy.
I'm afraid you have me at a disadvantage, Lady...
Mira.
Mira. Forrester.
I'm not used to being approached so boldly. But I'm glad you did.
No. This isn't going where we want it to.
I feel a bit out of place at big gatherings like this. So, what brings you over here?
Your rugged good looks.
Company, I'm afraid. Or were you headed for the wine and I got in your way?
Let's schmooze him. You look like you need company.
You look like you could use some company. What are you doing all by yourself?
I don't mind, really. I only came to discuss some business with Lord Andros. I'm told it's rude to leave early.
Hmm.
Oh? What kind of business?
I really shouldn't talk about it. Andros came to me in confidence.
Time to use those feminine wiles.
He wouldn't be pleased, I'm sure.
Whisper it in my ear.
If you like.
Wink, wink.
You can whisper it in my ear.
Well, I suppose I could just...
Lyman! What do you think you're doing?
Oh, God.
What? Nothing.
You
talking to somebody?
Him.
Excuse me?
Andros. We were just talking.
You were just talking to Mira Forrester.
Forrester? I didn't realize.
My lord?
Let me say this as plainly as I can.
Oh my god.
Don't ever meddle in my affairs again!
I thought he was gonna hit her. You're making a scene. Big oaf.
Lady Marjorie.
They really make her look cat-like in this. Hide, hide. Keys? Down, key? E? Q?
Lady Marjorie.
Shrubbery? My god, she was standing right there. She didn't see her. We didn't have to hit any hotkeys? Any quick time events? Didn't go so well.
That was quite a scene over there. Are you alright?
I'm fine.
No?
I can handle Lord Andros.
It's Lyman I was worried about.
Really?
What do you mean?
Honestly. That story isn't fit for a maiden's ears. Just be careful around him. All right?
Just tell me.
Just tell me, Lord Tarwick. It's important.
I may be willing to tell you.
For a price?
If you'll first tell me something about Sarah.
No.
Your help could save me a lot of embarrassment. I'd be very grateful, Lady Mira.
You better not get back to her.
What do you want to know about Sarah?
Sarah Durwell. Interesting name, that.
We can't tell him that.
Funny thing is, the last Durwells died off almost 200 years ago.
We can't tell her about her name. The last name is Flower.
Her family.
Maybe
something
we can...
isn't quite right.
We can tell him.
I'm not sure. You must understand, I can't court a woman just because I like the way she laughs.
I can vouch for
I
her family.
When I was at Highgarden.
Oh?
They're a small house these days. But very well regarded.
Sarah trusts us.
Right.
And she's helping us.
Well, that's a relief. For a moment, I thought...
And now, Lord Tarwick, it's your turn.
King's Landing is rubbing off on us.
Right. Lyman Lannister.
Right.
10 years ago, Lyman was injured at the tourney at Lannisport. He took a bad fall from his horse, needed milk of the poppy for weeks... just to keep from screaming.
Milk of the poppy.
And between us, he's never stopped drinking the stuff. Can't stop, actually. He spent all his money trying to get more. The man can't go a day without it.
Oh, boy.
So that's why he shakes.
And that's why he's so...
You mustn't repeat that, Lady Mira. You shouldn't even know about it. Besides, Lyman suffered enough embarrassment.
Then why did you tell
me? Every man's entitled to his secrets.
Then why did you tell me?
Because of... Well, maybe I shouldn't have. I'd hate for Lord Andros to trace this back to me.
You learned that from Andros?
The man's mouth is bigger than the Blackwater. Poor Lyman has no idea.
Huh.
Now, if you like,
we can use this to our advantage.
I have some arrangements to make. Lady Mira?
Lord, whatever your name is. Now do we tell him? Is there anything else to do except talk to him? Anyway, back out to the scene. There's nothing... This is probably a mistake.
I don't know, Sarah.
It is, of course, up to you. I just ask that you think about it.
Mira has proven herself to be an unreliable handmaiden at best. She's been dealing with Lord Tyrion behind my back.
Mira wouldn't do anything to hurt you, Lady Marjorie. I know she cares about you.
Do not make the mistake of thinking people who care about you will never betray you. Especially someone who has so much left to lose.
You mean her family?
You don't know what desires lurk in her heart.
Mira wouldn't.
Anyone would. Remember that.
It's pretty bold to be walking around. I mean, Marjorie can turn around at any moment. Alright, I think we gotta talk to Lyman, and we can use this information that we've gotten from what's-his-name to our advantage in some way. Not sure exactly how, but we'll find out.
Lord Lyman, we really need to talk.
I know what you're up to.
It's like shaking goblin.
I won't discuss my business with Andros, so please, please, just leave me alone. You've landed me in enough trouble. Just leave.
You're shaking.
Look at you. You're shaking.
It's an old injury.
But there's more to it than that, isn't there?
What are you saying? Either tell me what you want, or go bother someone else.
Andros has betrayed you.
Lord Andros has betrayed you. I know everything.
What? What do you...
The milk of the poppy. You drink it like wine. Ever since your injury at Lannisport.
You wouldn't... Andros wouldn't...
He's not your friend. He's been using you.
I trusted him.
Join forces with us.
He spilled your secrets. So why not spill his?
That's right.
Andros is hiring sellswords. Hundreds of them.
Ooh.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath.
Crap.
But Andros is doing it in secret. No one knows.
Until now.
Or at least, he doesn't want anyone to know.
And you're helping him.
I told him I'd keep quiet, but...
And you're helping him.
Yes, I've helped gather the men, but that doesn't... You bloody traitor.
It's on.
You promised me. Then you
it's
told
on.
Everyone?
What are you talking about?
You're a liar. I should never have trusted you. She told me everything.
Oh, boy. You gave us up. Hi. Uh-oh.
Lady Mira, you've just made a very grave error.
Yeah.
Very grave indeed.
You're afraid of a handmaiden.
Don't tell me you're afraid of a handmaiden.
Ooh. That's right. Walk away. Walk away, buddy. This is gonna get complicated, though. This is gonna get very, very complicated, isn't it? Okay. We've been running long enough. 2 episodes. Thanks for watching so much, and join me for the next episode when hopefully, you know, things... I don't know. We are victorious, and whatever the hell happens next. Thanks for watching. See you next time. And a bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.